Hey, Drew here with Plot First. Let's talk about Marcella Season 3. I'm not going to be going into spoilers in this review. I'm going to try to keep things vague. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and give me a like if you like anything I say. I always appreciate that. So getting into my thoughts on Marcella Season 3. So I think this is probably the weakest season. It was fine. It wasn't terrible, but it definitely lacked the intensity and the thriller aspects I feel that made the first two seasons really, really pop. Now, this show has always been kind of ludicrous, but I feel like it's always been the right kind of ludicrous, and I feel like this season could have used a little bit more ludicrous happenings. I feel like there could have been a few more really over-the-top shocking moments. There was one moment that stood out to me as being classic Marcella, and that was the scene in episode 3 at the police station, if you've already seen this and you know what I'm talking about. But otherwise, I felt like there weren't enough of those types of scenes. I always feel like the writers are kind of having a gasp behind the scenes, saying, oh, what ludicrously horrible thing can we think to have happen next? I actually laughed my head off at this scene in the second season when a car gets hit by a train, because I felt like the writers were just playing with the audience. And you know, I think that a lot of that is a problem for this show, because as many shows these days try to do, I think they try to subvert expectations. And I think this is kind of symptomatic of what the lesson a lot of shows learn from Game of Thrones, which is have shocking character deaths and shocking moments. But the problem with this is I feel like this show has a problem with character introductions to begin with. And this season, they introduce some characters, and you have to pay close attention because they're introducing so many characters at once, and you have to make sure you know how they fit into the story. But then when the characters end up getting killed right away or within a few episodes, and then their deaths don't really impact the rest of the story, you kind of question whether it was worth having those characters introduced at all if you were just going to kill them off anyway. Now, the setup this season is that Marcella is trying to infiltrate this family of criminals in Northern Ireland that are importing drugs and weapons, and they're run by this matriarch played by Amanda Burton. And they know that she's a former police officer, but they think that her name is Kira, and her handler is becoming concerned increasingly that Kira is, well, that Marcella is enjoying the role that she's playing of Kira just a little bit too much. And I think that the audience comes to question this as the series goes on. There's also this mystery of who is sending Kira these mysterious packages, and they seem to know her identity, they seem to know about her family, and they seem to know about some of the bad things that she's done in the past. And a murder in the first episode brings Rav back into the story, which is a little bit of a contrivance of the plot, but I think we're gonna be willing to forgive the writers this one, because it's nice to have Rav in this story, especially since I feel like there's a lot of thinly written and blandly acted characters this season. I think that there was some good performances in the first two seasons. I particularly thought Harry Lloyd was good in season one, but here I just felt like none of the actors stood out and none of the characters really stood out. And most of them end up dead anyways, so why do we care? That's how I felt. Someone else might feel differently, but I overall felt like, even compared to the cast of the first two seasons, which I don't think that this show has ever had an amazing cast compared to some of the other mystery thriller shows coming out of the BBC, but this one in particular, to me, this season in particular, had a very, very bland, uninteresting cast. I was getting Succession vibes from a lot of the actors in the Irish family. I felt like they were trying to kind of give us the Roy family vibes, but maybe that's just me. I think that obviously there are other family drama shows out there, but that's just the show that it brought to mind from my perspective, particularly the matriarch, who was giving me serious Logan Roy vibes, and there was a character that was constantly reminding me of Kendall Roy. Now, there were some interesting and thrilling moments during the season. Like I said, there was one moment at a police station in season 3 that got a reaction out of me. There was a shocking moment in the first episode that I didn't see coming and that really confused me when it happened. And I feel like it was a good idea to start this show in medias res, because That way they didn't have to explain all the aspects of how Marcella got into this situation, and it allowed them to just kind of explore her in this world. And I feel like it was interesting when she's trying to help the family, and that line between helping them so that she can help them eventually put them away, and when she's actually getting drawn into their lives and coming to perhaps see herself as having a role in this family and coming to enjoy the role that she has within this family. And I also thought that the power struggles within the family could be pretty entertaining, even if they were kind of melodramatic and soapy at times. But overall, I just felt like this season did not have the kick of previous seasons. I felt like the ending in particular, they resolved all the plot lines. They had built up all these conflicts between characters, and characters have struggles with each other and grievances with each other, but they resolved them all in a relatively anticlimactic fashion, and it didn't seem satisfying to me. I think some people might find it satisfying because technically a lot happened in the last episode, but it was a lot of events and not a lot of story, in my opinion. The only narrative arc that I felt was fulfilled adequately was that of Amanda Burton's matriarch. I felt like they did a decent job showing her as being this person who constantly puts family first and then ultimately causes all kinds of problems with her family through the way that she tries to control them. But that was the exception. Overall, I thought the characters were thinly written and bland for the most part, and I wasn't terribly interested in them when things weren't happening to them, which a lot happens. This is a very fast-paced show. There's a lot of, like I said, shocking moments. Everyone here is either a murderer or a murder victim. And Marcella, played by Anna Friel, continues to be compelling. The season does grapple eventually with what happened in the past season, what she found out happened with her daughter, and we get to see her grappling with that, what that means for her going forward. And I liked the way they ended this season for her character, because I felt like it does give them potential for a fourth season. But again, it's going to be very different from this season and very, very different from the first two seasons. She's kind of she's even further away from who she was in season one. And that's interesting because she started off as this relatively stereotypical investigative character, and she's become something very, very different. So overall, I would give this season, I'd say, a B minus. It wasn't terrible, it wasn't great, but I think that if you enjoyed the first two seasons, you'll probably enjoy it, while you'll probably agree with me that it lacked that special something that the first two seasons had. But let me know in the comments if you disagree. Let me know what you enjoyed this season. Let me know if you didn't think the characters were bland. Let me know which performances you enjoyed. You can watch more videos right now, and I'd appreciate it if you'd subscribe to the channel. That's my review of Marcella Season 3.